In this screencast, we are going to find the overall heat transfer coefficient for an insulated, thin-walled. And the reason we say it's thin-walled is that we can neglect conduction through the wall. And this is going to be counterflow concentric heat exchanger. It's going to be used to heat pressurized water using hot gases through a heat transfer area A equal to 20 meters squared. So let's see what this looks like. You see you have a fluid going in here and a fluid coming out here in opposite directions. So we know the following about this system. This heat capacity rate right here was found by multiplying the mass flow rate by the heat capacity. Remember that a joule per second is equal to a watt. So we're going to approach this using the NTU effectiveness method. So by definition, NTU is defined as U times A divided by C min, where U is the overall heat transfer coefficient, A is that area, and C min is the minimum heat capacity rate. So we're trying to find U, so let's rewrite it this way. So our U equals NTU times our C min divided by the area, which is what we're given. So we can determine the minimum heat capacity rate by consulting this table above. So now what we need is NTU. And to find an NTU, you use a table that gives the relationship of NTU to what's known as the effectiveness and the heat capacity ratio based on the type of heat exchanger that you have. So for our counterflow concentric heat exchanger, we find that this is equal to 1 divided by the heat capacity ratio minus 1, and this is all multiplied by the natural log of the effectiveness minus 1 divided by C sub R times the effectiveness minus 1. So our C sub R is equal to our C min divided by C max. And we can readily see that C min is equal to that of the gas, and C max is equal to that of the water. So our CR, our ratio, is just going to be 2,000 divided by 4,200, which is equal to 0.48. Now we need to find the effectiveness. So the effectiveness is equal to our actual heat transfer rate divided by the maximum heat transfer rate we could have for the system. So our heat transfer rate is equal to this heat capacity rate times the temperature difference of that fluid. So we can calculate this using either of the streams, as since the pipe is insulated, Q is the same for both of them. Which one should we use? Well, we have the delta T for our water stream, so let's use that to find our Q dot. So our heat transfer rate is going to be equal to our heat capacity rate, 4,200 watts per K, times the difference in temperature, which is 120 degrees C minus 40 degrees C, and that's going to be equal to 336,000 watts, or 336 kilowatts. Now, our Q max is equal to C min, which we know, times the inlet temperature of the hot stream minus the inlet temperature of the cold stream. And so this is equal to 2000 watts per K. And our temperature difference here is 350 degrees C minus 40 degrees C. And so our Q max is equal to 620,000 watts or 620 kilowatts. So when we divide 336 by 620, which is how we find our effectiveness, we calculate that the effectiveness is equal to 0.54. So now we have the ratio of heat capacity rates, we have the effectiveness, and we're ready to calculate our NTU. So that's equal to 1 divided by our 0.48 minus 1, and the whole thing is multiplied by the natural log of 0.54 minus 1 divided by 0.54 times 0.48 minus 1. And when we calculate this out, we find that the NTU is equal to 0.91. And from that, we can calculate the U using the equation from here. And our U is going to be equal to this NTU, 0.91, times our C min, 2000 watts per K, divided by our heat transfer area, 20 meters squared, and our U, or overall heat transfer coefficient, equals 92 watts per meter squared Kelvin. Note that we didn't need to find the outlet temperature of the gases. If you note here, we didn't put it on our table, but if needed, we could use the energy balance to determine it.